dirty bit.
Hi, and welcome to another segment of Fashion Forward. I'm your host, Black Barbie, and as you can see, I took a tip from our last Fashion Forward segment. This is called color blocking. Not sure if I got it right, but I'm color blocking right now. Now, of course, you know, there's a rule to color blocking. Only four colors, no more than four, so I got four. All right, so today on Fashion Forward, we have a very, very this is a top designer. I said she's so bad, she is taking Bronx by storm. I love the name of her collection, and it's called She Vogue. And I'm here with Marsha, the designer. Yes, yeah, so how are you doing today?
Great.
And I'm wonderful myself. Thank you, of course, for having me here. No, I got to, you know, trouble her a little bit. But of course, I'd like you to tell me how you came about with the name She Vogue, because I know you're Jamaican descent, and the way how it's spelled, you know, a lot of Jamaican might want to call it a different word, but tell me a little bit about that.
Well, Jamaicans will call it Chichi Vogue, but it's pronounced Shishi Vogue, and it means original fashion in French.
How long have Shishi Vogue been around?
Well, Shishi Vogue been out for 3 years now, going on four, and just waiting for the website to up and running, but you can still find me on Facebook and all of that if you need anything made.
Yes, of course, because she's been styling a lot of these girls, hot-hotting up in the dancehall scene, right?
Yep.
So, Marsha, I know you normally have a year-to-year fashion show. You want to tell the viewers a little bit about that?
Well, my year-to-year fashion show is always based off Shishi Vogue. So every year it's like Shishi Vogue part one, part two, and this year it's going to be on June 24th. Not sure where of the location yet, but like I said, you can contact me on Facebook on Marsha Williams on Facebook to get more details about that.
What's the inspiration behind your design?
Well, my inspiration behind my design are basically just looking at everything, my surroundings and stuff like that, and just get inspired by that. The line that I'm coming out with has to do with a lot of bandage dresses, like the one that I'm wearing right now, see-through, but it's still a bit classy, but it's see-through, never mind that. And some of the stuff are consist of glass, diamonds, Swarovski crystals, all of that. And I love working with spandex because it just clings to the body and it just gives you a perfect shape.
Nice, nice. So I'm curious, you know, as to your design. As you hear, she said it, this is the bandage look. And you hear she says she give you a little sexy, the see-through. You know, how would you class your design since you have the Vogue on it, and we see fashion, you know, with Fashion Week, and we see how they do it on the runway. How do you class your design?
Well, my design are classy and edgy and sexy, and why would you want to wear it?
So we heard from our last Fashion Forward segment about the color blocking. Are you incorporating that in your design, or are you just sticking to your style?
No, I love color blocking, and for this fashion show that I'm coming out with in June, it's going to be all about color blocking, and one of my dresses that I'm going to be showing tonight are also color blocking, so I love it, and I love your outfit too.
Thank you. Yeah, I got the thumbs up from the designer, and I'm so happy about that. All right, so right now, I would like for you to tell me about, you know, a few of your pieces that we're about to see. We're going to show you guys, you know, three of her designs. I want you to just elaborate on it for me.
Okay, the first dress consists of chains, glass, mirrors, and a lot of spandex and tulle fabric, and it's also inspired by the mermaid fit. The second dress is my favorite dress, the color block. It's lime green mixed with royal blue, and it's also one of my bandage dress, and the fabric in that is also spandex. The third dress is a dress that's inspired by polka dots with a little shimmer to it, spandex and sheer, and it also is a bit see-through as well, but it also fit the body perfectly.
So I know my viewers, they're looking and they're seeing your designs right now. You know, I know they're curious. Are you only designing for the petite? What about us curvy girls?
Well, I design for any size. It doesn't matter. It's just that it's custom made by artists. So if you're a little bit on the heavy side, you just have to come like 3 weeks in advance to get that custom made. But it, I don't prefer to work with anybody, any size. I don't care. I'm going to do it. It's business, it's business.
So since the name is Shishi Vogue, do you also design for men?
Well, I'm trying to come with the man's line. That's a bit difficult because I hate working with men. But I'm going to try that because the guys have been asking me like, okay, it's hot. Sorry for that. But I need a man's line right away. So I'm just trying to get that up and running. So that's my next step towards Shishi Vogue Man Collection.
Nice. So I know also that you're a mom. How do you balance, you know, being a mom and, you know, running a whole fashion line?
Well, that for me is pretty easy because I have a lot of support from my family. So that is no problem. I try my best to spend all my time with my son in the daytime. And I sew all through the night back till 5 o'clock in the morning. So it's no problem with when it comes to sharing time with my son and my business.
Nice. So if you could see yourself 5 years from now, where do you see Shishi Vogue?
Well, 5 years from now, I would like to see Shishi Vogue in Paris, Milan, all over, on the billboards, all of that. So that's my next step in the next 5 years.
So I'm curious, have you gotten any write-ups? Because you said you've been in, you know, the industry right now for like 3 years. You've been doing fashion and, you know, doing your fashion shows. Have you ever had any, you know, media write-ups?
Well, it's been pretty good on when it comes to media write-up. I've been in Jamaica Stars twice. Right here in the U.S., I've been in it once and twice in Jamaica from a customer that I don't even know, but place her order, send me her measurement, and it ended up reaching in the Jamaica Stars back in the yard. And also in Black and White this year, all my dresses got a good feedback, so I'm happy about that as well. And also, I've been interviewed by a couple of channels that's in the local area, and they're loving the line, loving it.
Yes, and we're loving it too, because also Marsha have styled me before for a stage show hosting alongside, you know, Nikki Z with a big stage show. But right now, talking about stage show and styling, have you, you know, ever styled any artists out there? Are you looking to style any artists, you know, in case they're watching right now?
Well, I've worked with a few upcoming artists that's coming out right now. Lady Ali, she's a female artist of the Bronx, and she's just been hooked ever since she came. So she's been in Jamaica doing this thing, all of those little concerts and stuff, and all of her pieces are done by Shishi Vogue.
So if you could style any artist out there, which artist would you love to style?
Well, an artist that I would love to style in the U.S. first is Rihanna. And back in Jamaica, I love the two sisters, Tammy and Tessa. I would love to design something for them. And also, I don't know, for the male, I would love to design something for Beanie Man.
Even though she says she doesn't really like deal with the man them, but Beanie Man is one of her choices. All right, so if you could tell, you know, give us a sum up and tell us, you know, what's the vision of Shishi Vogue, what would you say?
Well, the vision of Shishi Vogue that I'm trying to bring across, they're saying that dancehall is not fashion. I'm trying to show them that Jamaicans do have style. And yes, we're classy. And when I mean Vogue, it's dancehall and Vogue mixed together. So it's not going to be more so just pure skin showing. It's going to mean you could cover up and still be sexy and show a little skin at the same time. So that's the look that I'm going for. And that's also what the banded dress do, is just shape your body out. Just like how your skeleton would just fall out, it's like your skeleton without being inside of the body. So that's my look that I'm going for.
Nice. So if you could give, you know, our viewers a little fashion tip, what would you tell them?
Well, my fashion tip is I hate red lipstick on every outfit. The pink lips.
Like this.
Like black.
Like mine.
If you're not wearing pink and if your skin tone do not go with the pink, please don't put it on. And if you're wearing a garment that is see-through, always go with black underwear. It does not look tacky. Doesn't matter what skin color are you, but if you're on the light skin side, the best thing to go for is nude. always go perfect, and that's my fashion tip.
So you hear it, pink is good. So right now, I'd love for you, you know, I know the viewers out there would love, love, love to get in contact with you because they're looking at the dress and they're flawless. And you know, what's your Twitter, Facebook, and you know, any other network that they could get you at?
Well, you could find me on Facebook, like I said, Marcia Williams on Facebook.com. You could also email me at MarciaWilliams88@Yahoo. And you could also contact me on my business number, 718-924-8854.
You hear it here. She Vogue. And she's located right here in the Bronx, NYC. So this is another segment of Fashion Forward. Yes, no red lipstick unless you want to look older, but pink is a plus, but depends on your skin tone, of course. All right, so that's Fashion Forward for you guys. Until next time, keep where you have it.